Hello everyone, welcome back to CodingScientist.com. You are watching World of Sensors using Arduino UNO and Seed Studio's sensor expansion board along with 50 different sensors. Alright guys, so this is a pretty straightforward lesson. I'm going to show you about a sensor module called Chainable LED. So what is a chainable RGB LED, red, green, blue LED? This is basically based on P9813 chip. It's a micro small chip actually called P9813, which is embedded within the LED module, RGB LED module, which is a full color LED driver. It works as a driver board generating multiple colors, right? It provides three constant current drivers as well as modulated output of 256 shades of gray. Wow, fantastic, 256 shades of gray. It communicates with your microcontroller unit, that is the Arduino UNO, using two wire transmission, data and clock. It looks little complex, but good part is we have a library from the Grow, from Seed Studio itself. So they built a fantastic library to make things work. So this two wire transmission can be used to cascade additional chainable LED. You can connect in series multiple, hundreds, thousands, how many you want, right? You can connect in series just by plugging the wires, and the built-in clock regeneration enhances the transmission distance, right? So this Grow module is suitable for any colorful LED based projects. It can be used in drones, it can be in your robotics applications, which can trigger multiple color lights depending upon what function you are triggering and kind of thing. So go ahead and connect your circuit in your, you know, pin number 7, the D3 port, and I had already connected. You can see how bright it is. So if you can see the reverse side of the module, the sensor module, there is another serial port, right? So you can actually expand this kind of wire, another LED you can expand. So that way you can expand how many ever you want. So that is why it's called chainable RGB LED. And the LED is pretty bright, guys. You know, it's pretty, you know, you can see the brightness here. I'll just keep it on my hand and you can see how bright it is. And the color, the hue, HUE, saturation color keeps changing in this, you know, because it's RGB. You can actually write a program to change according to your, change the color according to your ambience, according to your room. You know, the best part is you can also connect LDR or any other sensor which can detect night and day and change the color according to your room. And it's pretty good, guys. It's pretty good. It's a pretty neat one. So let's look at the code. Let's go to my GitHub, and in GitHub, if you go to this section, Arduino sensor projects, go to my lesson number 17, chainable RGB. Now if you look at this code, there is a library called chainableled.h. In order to make your life more easier, so I have already placed the libraries here. So you can go to my GitHub, Arduino sensor libraries, this section, you can find chainableledmaster.zip. This is the file you need to download to your desktop. And from desktop, what you need to do, open your Arduino library folder, which should be ideally in your C drive or D drive, wherever you install your Arduino IDE. If you double click the folder, you can find another folder called libraries. In that library, you need to place this chainable LED master. Okay. So once you do that, come back here and then copy the code as usual. It's pretty easy. And then put the code here. And it's a pretty, you know, straightforward, easy to understand if you can understand this logic, how the hue saturation works. So, you know, it pulls up from your library file itself. And then go to tools, select your board, make sure to select your board. I'm showing this in every lesson so that you don't forget it. It's very important. And then select your COM6. COM6 is my port, yours is different. Upload the code and then you will get this particular action. So this is pretty straightforward, isn't it, guys? There are wonderful projects you can make using the chainable RGB module. If you are building a drone, you can use this RGB sensors. If you are building a robot, you can use this. Even in IoT applications or home automation, you can use these RGB LEDs chainable, with the chainable reactions. Think about it and come back to me with your ideas. We will build the projects together. I will see you soon. Goodbye.